This is how to set up your brand new Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 6. This guide could be used for any Samsung devices that are running Android 14 and using Samsung's own One UI 6.1.1. Just below the volume keys is your power button. This acts as your fingerprint sensor. Give that a press and you're greeted with Samsung Galaxy, and you're able to unfold and actually enjoy your larger 7.6 inch display here. Being registered blind, it's important to note the accessibility settings, so you have a little icon down to the bottom right hand corner. So some of the options inside here are talkback, able to change your contrast if you want to. So this would set then a white text on a black background. You also have the option to enlarge your display. There's also options to select to speak. There's other options for hearing impairment, visual impairment, cognitive function. I'm just going to change the font size, making it a lot easier for me to read when I'm setting up my video, and I can go back and can tap all the way back, or we could go all the way to the top here and select talkback, and this is what talkback does.
Talkback on. Welcome to talkback. Welcome to talkback, page 1 of 5. Talkback provides spoken feedback so that you can use your device without looking at the screen.
These are just a few of the accessibility settings and features that you'll find on a Samsung device, and don't worry, I'll be sharing my full accessibility review really soon. So make sure to subscribe for that, but let's go all the way back to the beginning and go through that setup process. We're going to tap start, and your first option is to select your language and then your region. So United Kingdom here, which is selected for me already. Tap next. Then we have those annoying terms and conditions that we must read, and hands up who hasn't read them. So simply tap these and then tap next. Our next option is easy setup. So you can either choose to set up from an Android or Samsung device. You could also set up from an iPad or an iPhone, or set up manually, which I'm going to do here. The next important step is to connect to your Wi-Fi connection at home, the office, when you're away on the beach maybe, there might be a Wi-Fi network. Find your Wi-Fi connection name, and then you're going to input your password. And you see the keyboard here for the first time. So it's split on the Z Fold option. But also, if you want a full-size keyboard, you could close this up and then use the cover display, and by pressing the power button, there you go, you've got a full keyboard that you can use there. So simply input your password. Once you've remembered your password and input it correctly, it will say connected and turn blue, and then we can unfold and carry on that larger display. So you can choose which way you would like to do this setup process. Tap next and we'll carry on. Staying on connectivity, it's about adding our SIM card. So you can insert your SIM card. You can use a dual SIM, you can use a mixture of eSIM and dual SIM, or you can set up later if you wish. Similar to one of our previous steps is about copying apps and data. So whereas this transferred everything from one of your other devices, this will take apps and data that you want to move over. So you can choose to copy if you wish. Again, that can be from Android or iPhone, and it will go through a setup process and give you a how-to guide. Then you're going to be asked to sign into a Google account. This is for all of your apps and Google services. So you can either log in if you have an account already. If you've forgotten your password, say you've forgotten password, or if you need to create an account, you can do. And again, I'm using the cover display to use a full-size keyboard here, or you could open your device to use that keyboard with a larger display. Once signed in, you are then asked to check the Google terms and conditions and just tap agree to these. Then we come onto a wide range of Google services. Again, you can toggle these on and off as you can see from the switch options. I leave all of mine on and then tap next. Here in the UK and throughout the EU, we have to select our browser option. You get a list of different options to choose here. You can toggle them to see their different preferences. But again, I'm just going to use Google Chrome. I've been having a look at DuckDuckGo, but let me know what you would choose below. Tap next and it does show you the rest of the list to make sure you've checked all of the options. Then we come on to protecting our device. There's a range of different options to have here. So you've got face recognition, fingerprints, a PIN, a password, or a pattern. And the fingerprint sensor is located, as I mentioned, on the power button. But I'm actually going to choose fingerprint to start off with. We also then need to set a secure screen lock, which could be your PIN, pattern, or password. In this instance, I'm going to choose a PIN between 4 to how many characters you want, and just repeat this process. So once your PIN has been entered, you will then be shown this image where you need to locate your fingerprint sensor, as I said, down the right hand side, an inverted button under the volume controls. Simply just tap your thumb away. It's not going to be a finger, I don't think, but till you get 100%, and then you can also add another finger if you wish. Then you'll be asked to access to your assistant with the Hey Google phrase. If you haven't set up a voice match on file yet, it will ask you to do this, but if you have one, then it will ask you if you'd like to use it on the lock screen as well. I use this so I can test my device thoroughly. It's just setting up some other options in the background, and then Samsung will ask you to sign into their account to get any rewards or extras for purchasing your device. With all new smartphones this year, it's all about AI, and of course you've got Samsung's AI built in with Chat Assist, Voice Assist, assistance with notes, and so much more. So make sure to check out my full review when I go through all the AI features. And let me know down below what you would like to see as well. So we're gonna tap next here to carry on. Then we have Samsung services that we can just see here. We can tap next to continue, then choose the light side or the dark side, and then you can tap next. And then finally is talking about protecting your device, not with security this time, but just looking after your device. This is such an expensive device. A folding device is such a new innovative technology that has changed and improved so much over the years, and make sure to protect it. So reading these key details, and then you're all set, ready to go and enjoy your brand new Samsung Galaxy device. I have enjoyed setting up here on the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 6. Switching between that cover display, I can quickly unlock and then open up to that huge 7.6 inch AMOLED display. With so much to go and explore with Galaxy AI, all the new features with cameras, with the options of the One UI 6.1.1, Android 14, and the knowledge knowing that this will be covered for at least 4 Android updates, your device will be impressive as time goes on. If there is anything that you need help with, please leave a comment down below, as I'll be more than happy to help. Any suggestions of videos you would like to see as well, drop a comment down below. As time goes on, I will be updating the video descriptions with new videos from the Z Fold 6. A huge thanks also goes to the team from Vodafone for letting me check out this latest device. I will leave a link in the video description to the best possible deal, so go and check that out. All that's left to say is make sure to subscribe if you haven't, to be updated when I release those new videos, and have a great day.